Welcome by Retro Machines. My name is Victor Bart, and in this video we're gonna prepare the Abit VP6 with CPUs and memory and try it out. But one thing before we start this video, I got extra Patreon supporters this month, so with that extra money I was thinking, let's invest that back into my channel. Let me show you what I bought. But wait, that's not all. I invested the Patreon money into RGB lights! Here we have the Abit VP6. It supports dual Pentium 3s on a PGA 370. It has a VIA Apollo Pro 133 chipset, 4 memory banks up to 2 GB, an HDP 4 time slot, 5 PCI slots. It has a standard layout of PS2 USB parallel COM ports, no sound or SCSI on board. It has an additional Highpoint IDE controller, but that is not the best IDE controller, so better don't use it. And for the rest, the board is a pretty basic layout with normal IDE floppy, the front connectors, no SCSI, no LAN. The maximum CPU support is Intel Pentium 3 1 GHz, so let's install two of them. And this is the original CPU of the Ultimate Year 2000 build. The board supports up to 2 GB SD RAM, and I have some 512 MB SIG here. But for testing, I will put in this 128 MB module. And later, I'm gonna swap it out for this set. For the cooling, I'm gonna use Golden Orb coolers. And the testing video card is a Matrox G100. I really hate the mounting system of this Orb coolers with twisting to put them in place. But when they are in place, they are really solid. Let's test out the motherboard. Okay, the fans are spinning. But no display. And also no beeps. So let's swap out the video card. And still nothing. I will try another memory stick. Still no sign of life. I had this board already running with one CPU. So let's remove the second CPU and see what the board will do then. We need to install the CPU terminator if we want to run the board with only one CPU. But luckily I have one for this board. No beeps, nothing. Maybe the main CPU is broken. So let's put in this Pentium 3600, and I had this board running with this CPU. And let's put an Easier cooler on the CPU for testing. Yes! With one CPU it is running, so maybe the BIOS is not up to date. Okay, I checked and we have the stock BIOS, but let's first check the other Pentium 3 1 GHz and see if it works. Okay, that's correct. So the second CPU works in the first slot. So maybe the other CPU is broken. But let's put the other Pentium 3 1 GHz back in this slot and see what happens. I think the original CPU from the Ultimate Year 2000 system is broken. Let me see, do I have another Pentium 3 1 GHz? I don't think so. I have a new plan. I found two 933 MHz Pentium 3 chips with the same stepping. So let's put this two in the motherboard. And maybe this even better, because this motherboard can overclock. And we can probably overclock the 933s to 1 GHz or maybe even more. Strange. It looks like this motherboard has an issue with CPU support. Let's put back the terminator and run it on a single CPU. I know this set of CPUs was working when I pulled it out of a system and upgraded that system to 1 GHz CPUs. Really strange. Let's remove this CPU and put the other 933 in. This board is really picky with CPUs, but it is an Abbott board, so maybe the caps are not that good anymore, because some here are a little bit dodgy. So let's put back the 600 makers which was working and then probably send it for repairs. Let's install the 2 GB memory and see if that will work. I have 2 Kingston modules and 2 Dane Elec modules. Okay, 2 GB of memory detected. I have 1 option left to test out the dual CPU support, because I found 2 Pentium 3666. So let's try them out. And we have a bent pin. Oh, we have a whole row of bent pins. I was thinking, let's make a quick little video, but it turns out to be a lot more difficult than planned. I really hate when pins will bend. And the pins are so small. So I'm now using a knife with a small blade. Okay, the pins are okay. Okay, this board is really picky with CPUs. So probably it's better to first get it fixed and then try out again with CPUs and updating the BIOS and stuff like that. Because this is not working how it should be. Sometimes videos don't go as planned with old hardware. I was thinking, let's make a nice short video about testing the board, putting CPUs on it, the memory, making a nice set for a new build or something. And then it turned out that the motherboard was really picky with CPUs. So my plan with this board now is to give it to a friend and he will recap the whole board. And then we will try again with CPUs and maybe I can see if I can score more Pentium 3 1 GHz CPUs, because I'm running a bit low now on them. And then we gonna try again. Thanks for watching. Please like and share this video. Subscribe and leave a comment. You can join Retro Machines on Facebook. And you can support me on Patreon if you want to see more RGB lights in my studio.
This train is inbound from level 3 dormitories to Sector C test labs and control facilities. If your intended destination is a high security area beyond Sector C, you will need to return to the central transit hub in Area 9.